two establishment Republicans not seeking re-election, Arizona's Jeff Flake, Tennessee's Bob Corker. President Trump has feuded with both of them in extremely personal terms. Joining us now, RNC spokesperson Kayleigh McEnany. All right, you represent the Republican National Committee. You are the Republican Party. So whose side are you on, the president or the establishment? Because they're at each other's throats.
Well, Stuart, we're on the side of the American people, and the American people sent an unmistakable message.
Okay.
Well, which means we side with the president. Look, you know, Senator Corker, the president won your state by 26 percentage points. Senator Flake, the president won your state by 4 percentage points. The American people want you to stand with the president. And if you want to represent your constituents, you've got to get behind this agenda. That means getting behind tax cuts, Obamacare repeal and replace. That's what we have to do.
I'm sorry, I interrupted you there before you'd given the full answer. And your full answer was you're siding with the president who leads the party. Well, that's intriguing. Now, do you know anything about Senators Corker and Flake and how they will vote come the tax package?
I suspect that they will vote on the tax package. They promised the people that. I hope they won't let their petty politics get in the way of that. And I just want to remind you, Stuart, you know, last year, last April, Senator Corker was saying President Trump is challenging the foreign policy establishment. In July, he said no one is more respected than President Trump. So what changed? He's not seeking re-election, but that shouldn't change the promises you made to the people. So I suspect they will get behind tax cuts.
Now, about this feud between Senators Corker and Flake and the president. The president said some pretty remarkable things in his tweets. Would you like him to tone it down?
I think the president has a right to fight back. He gets punched, he punches back. That's what the American people liked when they elected President Trump. I think he has a right to defend himself. It's unfortunate that, you know, these senators have decided to provoke this, because let's remember that they started these attacks. But I don't think it'll get in the way of the GOP agenda.
Do you think it's presidential when President Trump says things like that in his tweets?
I think it's presidential to defend himself. You know, it's as if, you know, some in the mainstream media expect the president to just take these punches lying down and just take attacks, sometimes from his own party, but most of the time from Democrats and from the mainstream media. I think he has a right to stand up and say, that's not fair, and I will attack back.
Wow, you're surprising me, Kayleigh. I didn't expect such unequivocal support for President Trump, who leads the party. And you're not telling him to calm it down, tone it down. You're full square with Trump. That's the position of the Republican Party?
That's right. We are fully with President Trump. And I also just want to emphasize, you know, these are two senators that are making these comments on the side. I do want to emphasize we had 51 senators vote on the budget. We had the House saying we're going to pass the budget without going to conference. So this isn't getting in the way of the agenda. These petty attacks, these personal jabs that these senators are leveling isn't getting in the way of progress.
All right. Kayleigh McEnany, RNC lady, thanks for joining us. We do appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Stuart.